Hello! On this week's Less Code, More Power, you're going to meet Matthew Perren, who built a book to manage his home library. Not kidding. Join us. Hello, and welcome back to Less Code, More Power. I'm your host, Donna Sarkar, and my lovely co-host is...
Sarah Critchley. Hi, everyone.
Today, we have a very unique guest. His name is Matthew Perren, and he has solved a global problem that you're going to recognize using the Power Platform. Hi, Matthew.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Yes, I'm good. I'm good. Knee-deep in snow in Scotland here.
I love it. There's talk of snow here, end of days. Tell us a little bit about you, your job, what you do, and tell us about this amazing project you've created that you're going to give us a preview of today.
Okay, so I am a Business Central consultant working for KIC ICT, who are a Glasgow-based consultancy firm. And I've come a wonky way into tech because I'm a theatre studies graduate who was too scared to perform. So I got a job working in a bookshop back in 1985. And I stayed working in bookshops for like 30 years and went all over the country opening new bookshops in Shrewsbury, Preston, Newcastle, Edinburgh. And I got to Edinburgh and just kind of stuck. So I've been here for a very long time and ended up working, running a huge bookshop in Prince's Street in Edinburgh. And then going off and working for the Scottish Library Association for a bit. And then working in another bookshop in another part of the city. And then a friend of mine runs a book wholesale business and needed somebody to help out. So I ended up running that for them for 12 years. And then made a hop into doing consultancy for Business Central because we'd installed that as one of our systems that we ran. So all kinds of stuff. I used to be a pig farmer when I was a teenager. All kinds of.
I knew he was amazing. I knew. Yeah. Oh my god! The fact that you just said you managed like 100 bookstores as well. Yeah. I was like, this is meant to be. Clearly. Yeah.
So the reason I did that was because I've always loved reading. It was the one thing that I felt I was actually good at. And no one ever criticizes you for being bad at reading once you've learned how to do it and you're doing it in your head. No one sits there and goes, you pronounced that wrong because it's all in here. So. When the pandemic came and we went into lockdown in Scotland, we started up a WhatsApp group in our street, and it's been brilliant. It's been absolutely fantastic, and we've all got to know each other much, much better than we had. And you know, if there's a positive to come out of all of this, it's that the community's really kind of got together. And one of the things that people wanted to do was to be able to swap books because they weren't able to get out and do anything else. And I'd harbored a secret ambition for years and years and years to have a little library on the fence of my house, a free library that people can just open the door of and go in and you know, borrow books. And I've got loads and loads and loads of books here. That's a small fraction behind me, a tiny fraction behind me. And I've probably given away to charity more books than I currently own. But we had this plan for the library. So I'd been meaning to do this for years and I thought, well, this is a great opportunity. So we got... I got everyone to give me timber from their gardens and stuff, and I built a library, fixed it to the fence, filled it with a whole bunch of my books, and the whole thing kicked off. And pretty soon it was bulging and there was far too many books in there. So I thought, well, I need to work out how to take stuff out. And I thought, well, you can't just go in and go, well, I'll just take this out because I don't like it. So I thought, well, what I need to do is I need to, old bookseller here, going, I need to know what's working best. What are the things that people are borrowing and bringing back all the time? And what are the things that are just sat there doing nothing at all? And I thought, what I need is I need to build myself an app. So I need an app with a barcode scanner so I can quickly go in every day and go blip, 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 and then be able to go and analyze that data in Power BI and make some decisions about what goes and what stays. So I've been fiddling around building apps during lockdown. My daughter, my daughters are 13 and 15, and my 13-year-old daughter, when we went into lockdown, was in 17 teams from school, and she couldn't keep track of what she was. But yeah, exactly. She couldn't
17.
Keep 17. I know. It's mental.
I mean, I guess she's enthusiastic, right? I guess.
No. This is just all the subjects that she was studying. just that this is what the school said she had to do. So,
oh my God, all mandatory. Oh my gosh.
I don't know. So they're all posting. So this is like first year of secondary school.
This is like Cruel and Unusual. Oh my God.
Cruel and Unusual. So the teachers are all kind of posting things, and they're sticking stuff in files, and they're posting stuff in the posts, and they're putting things in assignments, and she can't work out where she is, what she's supposed to be doing, what everything is. So I built her an app using Power Apps and a couple of SharePoint lists. And we worked out a way of going, I've got to do this piece of work in this subject, and it's due in on this day. And she had that on her phone, and she could go into Teams, and she could work out where everything was on a Monday, and then she's got her list of things she needs to do.
That's amazing.
So that I've done that. What I need to do now is work out another app. I need to work out another app. And the library thing came along at the same time. So I thought, well, this is a really good idea. So I was talking to a friend of mine and basically told her that I'd already done it, just to try and impress her a bit. And she said, oh, that's great. That's great. I should see it.
Yeah, it's already done, except for the book.
I don't know. It's Alison Mulligan, who I think is an MVP. So I told Alison I'd already built it to try and impress her. She went, oh, that sounds great. And I thought, oh, Christ, build the bloody thing.
I love that. That's like brutal accountability, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. That's what comes of being gobby and a bit overconfident, I think. So what I did was I put two SharePoint lists together. I've got a list of all the books that are in the library. Yeah. And then I've got another list, which is just an accumulating list of those books every day. So there's I go in, I scan them, and I save it to the second list, and it just goes this book this day, and then the next day it goes the same book this day, and then I've got some Power BI that has taken me ages to work out how to make it work properly. These books have been around for ages, and they're really dull. No one wants them. Get rid of them. And so I can then clear out those books. And I've basically added functionality to the app a bit at a time. Started off just being a scanning app, just to see if I could do it. And then I managed to add in the kind of the patching it into the second list.
Quick question, Matthew. Did you, based on that data that you saw, just before you, I'm so interested in seeing it right now. But in terms of the data that you saw, was it what you expected? Or was it actually quite interesting to see the books that were probably the least popular?
So I'm going to be honest with you. It's still quite early, and so I've been sort of trying to kind of analyze it. What's disappointing is that there are certain things. I tried some experiments where I took some of my very favorite books and went, I'm going to put this in.
Yeah.
I started out with a Facebook page, which didn't really work. So it's now got a Twitter account, which nobody follows it. But doesn't
we all go and follow it. You need to put this in chat. Yeah.
Well, I will do. I will do. And
famous.
What happens now is if anything new arrives in the library, I scan it, and the scanner goes, oh, I don't recognize that. What's that? And so it then keeps the barcode, takes it to an edit screen. I dictate the title just using the phone. So all the titles look really wonky because none of them have got capital letters. Then I save it back to the list. And then there's a flow that coming after that, a little tiny flow, which I'm immeasurably proud of, but it's the simplest thing that just tweets it. Goes, there's a new book.
Oh,
in the
library. That's cool.
Well, it's great, except it's howling into the wilderness because there's nobody.
Well, it's going to be there, right?
And actually, it'd be great if you guys followed the account, but of course, you're nowhere near where I live in Edinburgh, so it doesn't really.
Donna has like global reach. I think she knows like people everywhere.
Or that tweets, your book library that tweets is going to be famous. This is so cool.
I love that. Like, I didn't even know that bit. I knew that you built the library and stuff and you did the scanning piece, but I didn't know you had the social media part, which is amazing.
That's the thing, Sarah. Probably when I spoke to you, I didn't, but I keep adding things. The next thing is I want to try and work with the Google Books API to scan the barcode when it's a new book, and the barcode goes off and it brings back the author, which is the piece of data I don't currently have. I can add it because there's only like 50 or so books on the list. The author, a bit of blurb, and the cover, and then the tweet could include the cover, and that just is that's
that would be really that would be amazing. So I'm too excited now, Matthew. Show us what you've got, what you've brought for us today.
All right, okay. I'll do a little demo then. I videoed it. I did a screen capture on my phone because you can't demo it on Power Apps. So hang on a sec.
So for the audience, while you get that ready, Matthew, for the audience, we'll make sure all the links are like kind of down below in the description. So you can go ahead and follow the library, follow Matthew, and definitely check that out.
Okay. Yeah. I just like that a guy with stage fright became a pig farmer and a local bookstore magnate, a library magnate, and now has a bookstore, now has a library who tweets.
I know. A tweeting library. I'm so jealous a little bit as well. Like having a bookstore, I've got so many questions. Like I'm going to be like DMing you on Twitter. Like, what was it like? Like, tell me everything.
Okay. Can you see this?
Like surrounded by sheep and books somewhere. Off the country. Oh, yeah.
Can you see this?
Yeah, we can see.
I see.
You can see this. Okay, right. So I'll talk you through it. So I'll press play and I'll show you what I did. So what you do is you go in and you hit the scan button and you scan a barcode. Mm-hmm. And then it goes and then it comes back with the book. You hit the save thing, scan another barcode.
Oh.
Hit the save button. Scan another one. And you go, I don't want to keep that. I'm going to chuck that one away now.
So that's when it's like no longer in the library.
Mm-hmm. And then you see the doll's house in the corner. Then you scan another one and it goes, hey, I don't know that one. What's that? And I had to scan it twice. Don't know why. And then it brings up the edit screen. And I didn't dictate it. I typed it in this time round. And this is a book about my favorite band, The Fall. And you go into the status, you go, it's in stock, and you save it using the button at the top right, and there it is.
Nice.
Okay, really straightforward. And then there's the big midweek on my SharePoint list, and there is Chasm City, which is the one I removed, highlighted there, with removed now flagged on SharePoint.
Look at that.
That's cool. I've got so many like questions and ideas for this as well. Like, do you reckon you'd love to put into the feature, like the app, like if someone could actually query what's in and what's not?
Yeah, I'd really, well, that's the other thing is I'd really like to kind of try and build a website off the back of it that was using, so I probably shouldn't use SharePoint as my data source. I want to try and put that into the dataverse at some point or another. And then run a simple website off the back of it, which you see as a project, right? I look at this and think, well, okay, I could go and try and teach myself how to build a website as a thing just to learn how to do. So there's one idea of building the library, which I built myself. Do you want to see a picture of it, by the way? I'm not sure.
Yeah, for sure. Like pretty much our answer is always going to be yes to those kind of questions.
We're like, yes.
Hang on. Can you see that? No? Yes? No?
No, we can't see that yet.
Never mind. Okay, well, maybe I have to work that out.
That's okay. We can always, like, what we can do in the description for the audience, for everyone watching, we'll include some links in the description that kind of show you a little bit, like, where you can find the information. Obviously, we'll include all of Matthew's social links as well, so they'll be able to find it in the description below.
By the way, that's the tweet. You can't see that at all, but that's the tweet that it tweeted. To say the big midweek had been added to the library, but you can't see that because it's far too bright.
But as soon as you add the Twitter account, we're going to follow it and tell everyone to follow it. Yeah.
Don't know if that's any better. There you go. That's a.
Oh, it's a little bit. Yeah, we can see that now. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So that's what it tweeted last night when I.
I love it. That is cool. I love that your library tweets.
It's nice, isn't it? I like the fact that you think it's the library that does it, which is really sweet.
It is Matthew. Don't modify the magic
right now. Yeah, the library that tweets, that is amazing. I love this. This is so cool. Okay, so we ask all of our guests to assign homework to our audience. What have you got?
So my homework, which you'll be disappointed to hear, it's not book related really, but it's barcode related, and I was thinking about what I could do with this. And thought, what I'd really like to do, I make shopping lists all the time to go to the supermarket. And then I go to the supermarket and I have to wander up and down all the aisles and keep checking my shopping list to go, where's that again? And have I got everything on my list? And if the list has got like 50 items on it and I'm in fruit and veg and bananas are at the bottom of the list, I then end up going back to fruit and veg for bananas.
Yeah.
And I thought, most of the food in your house has got a barcode on it. So you could start yourself a little food inventory using barcodes. Mm. And then you could just sitting in an idle moment in front of the telly with your list of barcoded food, go, well, I know that's in aisle one, and I know that's in aisle two, and I know that's in aisle three. And then you could use barcodes to scan the things you wanted to go and buy as you ran out of them. And then it'll give you a shopping list that would tell you where in the shop to go based on the shop. So someone should go off and build that, I think. I'm going to try it and I'll race you.
That's amazing. That's great homework.
I have never thought about barcoding before, but now I'm going to go barcode the heck out of everything in the kitchen, much to my husband's chagrin. So. All right. We are, of course, out of time, but thank you, Matthew, so much for being here with us today. It has been such a pleasure to hear this story. Definitely, Sarah, one of the most unique ones we've had.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Lots of fun.
Thank you. All right, everyone. Until next time, less code,
more power.